today's daily debate question for the MMA Junkie Radio team. In what way class Jon Jones versus Daniel Cormier trilogy happen if the fight gets made? Light heavyweight, heavyweight, or a catchweight? Goes.
Definitely not a catchweight. I am going with heavyweight.
Why not a catchweight?
What for? What is that going to prove?
Just so one dude doesn't have to kill himself to get to 205, I guess.
I'm looking at heavyweight because I think it makes the most sense for Jon Jones. If I'm Jon Jones, I'm asking for this fight at heavyweight. Because at the end of the day, when people are talking about who the greatest fighters of all time are, we really have to nitpick on them. And wouldn't it be nice for him to say, see that other dude in the conversation right there, Daniel Cormier? I beat him twice at light heavyweight, and then I went up to heavyweight, his stomping grounds, and I took his title there too. So let's knock him out of the way, and what else you got for me? Bring on GSP arguments, all those other arguments that you can make. I think that would be a big skin on his wall. I think it would help him out if he did it at heavyweight. At the end of the day, when they fight at 205, they're heavyweights anyway.
Man, normally I'd bust your balls because I think you said the exact same thing yesterday. I'm just going to ask you, who's drafting next in the NBA lottery? But it applies because this has been a hot topic for the last 24 hours, and I understand your point. Even though Jones, because yesterday I had read off some quotes that Jones has zero interest, you're saying
he should have interest.
He needs to have the interest.
He needs to have interest because that'll help him. That'll
Maybe
help his legacy.
Maybe his ego is telling him, I don't even need all that. I am the greatest. See, he needs to take a loss. If he takes a loss, then if that's something that stirs his soul, you know, to be regarded as a GOAT, or if he feels like, man, I fell behind GSP or somebody, then maybe that's the move he would need to make. Look, I'm in agreement with you. That's what I really want to see. I don't want to see the other guy go down to 208, 205. I think he's just, if he started off as a heavyweight, I've known him as a heavyweight, who dropped down to light heavyweight, had a successful run as a light heavyweight, just came up short against his greatest foe, but is still arguably one of the greatest heavyweights. I feel like Daniel Cormier is this close to cementing himself as maybe the greatest heavyweight, and he wasn't about a year ago. All right, the argument was still Fedor because of what he did for a long time, despite some of the losses. Kane, it's just that he had been away for so long. He had five fights against two guys, you know, JDS and Bigfoot. And then he came back and got smashed by Ngannou. And so, like, your argument literally doesn't hold up. It holds up 3 years ago, but you're saying it and you're arguing it. It's the same guy, same as the guy that's arguing with Fedor. He's trying, like, oh, God, don't bring up Mitrione. Oh, God, don't bring up Dan Henderson, you know. Verdum was up there for a while as well because he had finished both of those guys. But then, who was it? Volkov gave him a loss. So right now, if you think about it, a lot of people were saying Miocic up until when he got knocked out by Cormier. He had three title defenses. He had a good record. Wore the strap. Traveled to, you know, to beat. He actually beat one of the guys being discussed in Verdum. But then he lost to Cormier. And anybody that doesn't know Cormier's history forgets Strikeforce. And prior to Strikeforce, he went out there, captured a couple regional belts. He won the Strikeforce Grand Prix. He beat guys like Josh Barnett. You know, in the Strikeforce Grand Prix, because he kind of came in as an alternate. And then, as a heavyweight, he knocked out Stipe Miocic. And so that's another guy that's in the argument. And then he beat Derek Lewis, who's very widely recognized as one of the top heavyweights right now of this era. If you can add Jon Jones and one more, he breaks Miocic's record. And I believe he's undefeated as a heavyweight. I mean, literally, he could be that, you know, and still be involved in GOAT talk. So it's for, I guess, a different reason maybe, but I think we're on the same wavelength. 56% said heavyweight, 30% said light heavyweight, 14% said catchweight. So I threw catchweight in there when I gave the editors this idea, and I thought it was going to come up like 2%, and I thought the editors were going to go, you idiot, don't throw that one in again. Actually, if you guys want to know a fun fact, I even threw in one more option. I said they should run it back in the MGM hotel lobby, but they decided
that
not
would
put
be
that
100%.
One in.